Hello everyone, this is Ninja Girl Sakura1 here, and it is time to review Yashahime, Princess Half Demon Episode 12, Night of the New Moon and the Black Haired Toa. Obviously, the episode title is a nod to Episode 14, I think it was, of the original Inuyasha series, Mystery of the New Moon and the Black Haired Inuyasha, which revealed human Inuyasha for the first time and told us about the whole thing where half demons lose their power on the night of a new moon. And this episode obviously deals with the same sort of situation. And while not as good as Mystery of the New Moon and the Black Haired Inuyasha, because that episode was really good, this episode was also fairly solid. There was a couple things that continuity-wise were a little bit eh, sort of. But overall, I had a good time watching the episode. It wasn't bad. So yeah, the episode begins with the return of Konton, who I think was either in episode 7 or 9, maybe? It's been a little while, so I'll apologize. But he's another one of the four perils, and he managed to get away from the girls and survive. So, yes. And since he wants the Rainbow Pearls, he decides to send another half-demon after them, Nikosen. So, yeah. He sends them off to find the girls and get their Rainbow Pearls. And to do so, he starts destroying a mountain, basically, and that leads to the Demon Slayers hearing about it, and that's when we pick up with the girls, and Kohaku tells Toan Setsuna about it, and asks them to go take a look, see what's going on. They agree, and the Demon Slayers agree that they'll meet him later, but they want them to go ahead and investigate. So they do. And meanwhile, Maroha also had heard about this, and was also looking into things, which is where Toa and Setsuna come across her. So, reluctantly, because Maroha does not want to split the bounty on this, but, yeah. She, of course, takes her cousins along, and, yeah. But on the way up the mountain, Setsuna notices something's going on with Toa, that her heart's beating faster than usual, and she doesn't sense any demonic energy from her. She knows something is up. So, yeah. And then, Nikosen appears, throws out a miasma, I guess you could call it, like Naraku used to use, a poison mist, in other words, and it starts to affect Toa immediately. And luckily, Maroha, she has the robe of the fire rat, I think that's what it is. It's never been confirmed that that's what her cape is made out of, I don't think. But I'm pretty sure it is, so she uses that to cover her mouth, so she doesn't breathe it in. And I think Setsuna just put on her mask, because Demon Slayers have masks. You know. We've seen Sango use one. So, yeah. But Toa is out for the count, and Setsuna tries to take care of her, while Maroha fights Nikosen. But being she's having to cover her mouth, and it can only use her sword with one hand, she's not striking as hard as she normally would, and yeah. So, her and Setsuna basically switch positions. Maroha takes care of Toa, Setsuna goes in and tries to attack. And, yeah, for a minute, it looks like Setsuna had won, but when we see Maroha and Toa again, unfortunately, we see that it was a trick, that Nikosen was still alive. They thought they had destroyed him when they destroyed his head, but no. His body is his main core, and yeah, he appears in front of Setsuna, or no, Toa and Maroha, and yeah, destroys the bridge they were crossing and makes them fall to the ground. And that's where we see the girls, Maroha and Toa, stuck in a cave, and they go in there to hide. And that's when we see that Toa has completely turned human, her hair has grown longer, it's black, her eyes are normal color brown now, she has no demonic power at the moment, and Maroha doesn't really know what this is, because she had never had to deal with it, apparently. But to get some answers, she uses her rouge, or pretends like she's going to use it, and looks for Myoga, or calls out for him. And of course, Myoga's right there, and explains everything that half-demons lose their power in the night of the new moon. We know that, but obviously Maroha does not. And she is curious. She's like, wait, that's never happened to me, ever. So, what's going on? Why have I never experienced that? And, well, Yoga basically explains, which I figured as well, since she's only quarter demon, it doesn't really affect her, it doesn't really happen to her, because she's more human than anything already. So, lucky for her. But when Toa hears about this, she starts worrying that Setsuna is going through the same thing. And the episode kind of leads you to think that maybe she is, because her hair is black already, so you wouldn't really know, right? But yeah, especially when she's worried about Toa Amaroha when she figures out that the Nikosen she beat was fake. So yeah, she goes to meet up with the Demon Slayers who had arrived at the bottom of the mountain. And their plan is to basically burn the mountain down, but Setsuna's like, well, let me go look for them first before we do something that rash. So yeah. So she takes off looking for them. Maroha, meanwhile, does something incredibly smart to hide from Nikosen, who's still looking for them. He kind of knew they wouldn't die from falling from that distance, I guess. But, yeah. Maroha uses her spiritual power to raise talismans and put up a barrier. Which, we've never seen Kagome do that. Have we? I'm pretty sure we haven't. But maybe she did learn how. But yeah, way to go, Maroha! Spiritual power coming in clutch. So, yeah, and you'd think that'd be enough to protect them until the sun rises, right? That they would be okay. But, unfortunately, that hides Maroha's energy from Setsuna, who's looking for them as well, on Killala. So, yeah. It's a double-edged sword. Setsuna can't find them, and neither can Nikosen. And since Setsuna can't find them, she goes back again to the Demon Slayers and gives them the okay to destroy the mountain to get rid of Nikosen and the poison mist. And in the flames, it ruins Maroha's talismans, and Nikosen finds them, attacks them, nearly gets them with this. He almost turns them to stone, it looks like. I guess that's what it is. I'm not exactly sure. But thankfully, Setsuna finds them as well and stops them and frees them. She almost gets hurt, but right in the nick of time, like in Inuyasha, always in clutch, the sun rose, and Toa got her demonic powers back. And she wins. So yeah, victory! Oh, almost forgot. With Setsuna. No, she doesn't experience the whole new moon thing. I almost forgot to mention this. I apologize. But the reason why, this is something that's strange. The reason they give is because of the dream butterfly. Which, I don't know if stealing dreams would steal your ability to lose your power on the night of a new moon. Maybe because she never sleeps, so everything's like the same day in her mind. I don't know. It's very weird. That was kind of a weak explanation, if I'm being honest. But yeah, that's the reason why she apparently has not experienced it. But anyway, yes. As I was saying, Toa wins, the girls are safe, and unfortunately, again, Maroha cannot claim her bounty, and she was planning on using Nikosen's regenerating head as an endless bounty, but rip. Those plans are a bust, unfortunately. And even worse, yeah, Konton was watching, so he now knows about their weakness. Which is not good for one of the four perils to know about that. Although you'd think they would have known that already, but maybe not. Who knows? They do, half demons do keep that very secret for a reason. So, yeah. But he knows now, because he was watching, and that's kind of where the episode ends. So, ooh. Will that come into play in the future? We'll see. I don't know, but boy am I curious. So yeah, overall, fun episode, I enjoyed it. Inuyasha's first episode as human, Inuyasha in episode 14 was better, but this wasn't bad either. So yeah, it was a nice little nod, it wasn't bad, had a good time with it. Seeing Maroha use her spiritual power was very clever, and thankfully she wasn't just immediately defeated, thank God, because that really is irritating. Maroha knows how to fight. She has proven that she does. She doesn't need to get pushed aside and beat every time. so that Toa and Setsuna can come in and save the day. That's kind of unfair. But anyway, at least she got to do stuff this time. She wasn't immediately defeated. So that was good. And now, for those who have not seen the next episode preview, close the video now because I'm going to talk about it a little bit. So yeah. Next episode preview spoilers. 3, 2, 1. Alright. Next episode, Miroku's coming back! Yay! I had heard that he should be coming back, but it was just on Twitter, so I wasn't sure if it was actually true. Always wait for official sources, you know? So, yeah, but it is! And we see Sango in the preview as well, but we don't know if that's a flashback or not. Maybe not. I'm hoping not, because I'd love to see her too. And we see one of the twins, one of their daughters, as well in the preview. Or was it just some screenshots, the official Twitter release? I think it was just screenshots. Yeah, it was screenshots that the Twitter released a little bit ago, which was great. So, yay, we're getting to see Hisui's sister, one of them. Amazing. And apparently he's been going through 1,000 days of training as a monk, which makes sense. Because remember in episode 1, he was like, ugh, if only I had my wind tunnel, I would be of more use, I'd be able to help more. So, yeah, he probably decided, okay, I'm going into training so I can help my friends more. Good enough. And apparently he's been working his butt off, his hair is longer, he does look a little bit older, so it's going to be good to see him again, it really is. Although, I wonder who's going to play him in the English dub when that does come out, because Kirby Morrow unfortunately passed on, he won't be able to voice Miroku anymore. But we will always remember him for all the wonderful work that he did, so yeah. But I'm excited! Also, in one of the screenshots released, even more interesting still than Miroku's return, Demon Setsuna, full Demon Setsuna. Remember what happened to Inuyasha? Yeah! Looks like that might be happening to her. We saw a picture of her with longer fangs, marks on her face. She doesn't have the red eyes like Inuyasha used to get, but every half-demon's different, or maybe her demon blood hadn't fully taken over just yet, but Inuyasha used to get vicious when he was like that, so let's see what happens with Setsuna. Oh boy. Also, what would trigger that, though? Inuyasha had Tetsuya to keep his demon blood in check. Setsuna does not. We don't know how that works for her in her case, because she doesn't have like a sword that would, she has her her weapon, what is it called, I keep forgetting, Naginata, she has that, but that wasn't made from like say Sesshomaru's fang like Tetsuya and Tensega were, so I don't, or maybe it was, I don't know, I have no idea, but maybe that was keeping her blood in check? I don't know. I'm curious. I'm very curious. So yeah, things are getting more and more interesting. Hopefully it will stay that way from here on out. So yeah, I think that will do it for this episode review, though. I hope you guys enjoyed and are looking forward to Miroku's return as much as I am, and Sango's return, hopefully. I hope that's not a flashback. Also, Miroku, tell Maroha what happened to her parents. I need to know. The weight is killing me. I know I say it a lot, but I need to know. Where are they? Why aren't they with their daughter? I need to know. But yeah, that will do it for this video. If you enjoyed, leave a like, share it around if you want. And yeah, if you want to follow me on Twitter, help the channel on Patreon, those links are always in the description below, and I would vastly appreciate it. But no pressure, of course. But yeah, I will see you guys next time for episode 13 with Miroku and Demon Setsuna. It should be a wild ride. But till then, see you later.